comments. Yeah.
So, by the way that you sing, you're typically a bass?
Yeah, tenor, actually.
Tenor?
Yeah.
Okay. You have a lot of power in the lower notes, but when you get to the higher, it seems like you're using your throat rather than your stomach and your diaphragm to push the air. You have that power in the low notes because it seems like you're comfortable there. You get to the higher notes and you tense up. So while you're trying to get to the higher note, try and push with the same strength that you do when you're at the lower notes. And you should hit them easier. They should sound cleaner and stronger.
Mm-hmm. Trevor?
I can think of so many different improvements from the last time I heard this piece. There was a lot less sliding between pitches. There was a lot less of that. Your pitches were a lot more spot on. A little bit shaky in the upper register, but it's the upper register. I can't sing up there either. Like he said, there's a lot of power in the lower notes, and I really like that. There was a lot more dynamic contrast this time around, especially in there was a lot more piano in your pianos than usual, and I really enjoyed that. You did a really good job this time.
Good. somebody else? Yes. Yeah, did you warm up before this?
I didn't really have time.
That's all right. Yeah, I agree. I think it's more about relaxing, getting this to relax. I just feel like your voice is transitioning at that point, and you're struggling to just open it up. I think you can do it, but you're just struggling to open it up. It's nerves, it's preparations, all that stuff. You'll get there. I think, I'm not a vocalist, though. Vocalists can help me. I feel like if you open up, it's going to help. The other thing I wanted to say, wind players and singers, if you're diminuendoing a line, specifically a line that doesn't have any breathing in it, so it's just melismatic or it's just one long note, do you need more breath support or less breath support? You need more. So there's a couple places in here where you have these like dotted half notes that diminuendo. Don't give up on them. Keep this engaged. In fact, what I would do is actually feel, while you're rehearsing, feel this thing tighten up and start pushing. And that's gonna help you maintain your pitch when you're trying to get through those lines. It's really hard to do. It's one of the hardest things you have to do, especially when you get into the high register and you're trying to diminuendo those lines, right? Without the pitch going south. We don't want that to happen. We wanna maintain that pitch. But you're doing a pretty good job of it. Can I ask, because you guys have said that he played this last week, how long have you been working on this? Like on and off, whatever. Okay, cool. And how is this experience? This goes for a lot of you because it's a different experience. How is the experience coming back to a piece you haven't performed in a while?
Familiar, but hard because of
the environment. Sure, yeah. It's a really, if you guys get the opportunity, it's hard to do it in school. If you got the opportunity to revisit a piece that you've already learned, it's a lot of fun. It's very interesting coming back to something you haven't seen in a while and seeing how much, for example, these guys point out how much you've grown since last semester, which can be very cool. All right, thank you very much, Devin. Appreciate it.